There's a lot to cover and you have to do it in a limited time frame. So we didn't have this book at our times, but I think it's a beautiful book. The more I talk about this book, it's less. You learn how to make death certificates, you'll learn about injury marks, and you'll learn about weapons and everything that you need on ophthalmology is covered. Let's move on to ENT, which is ear, nose, throat. Trust me on this, if you read this book, you will genuinely develop real love for the subject. But you can use them for weightlifting also, like they work. You know, certain short answer questions, I think it has been beautifully dealt with. So apart from these books, there is one book that please close your eyes and just buy this book. It's you'll have to attend postmortems, and I think that will also be very interesting. Namaste everyone, welcome or welcome back to the channel. I hope all of you are doing great. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please click the subscribe button down below. So today we are going to talk about the third year medical textbooks. So let's begin. We'll start with FMT, which is Forensic Medicine and Toxicology. So earlier it was included in second year of med school, but right now it has shifted to third year of med school. So we are going to talk about it here. Now, FMT, the book that you should read, is ready. Now, I know that it appears to be a big book and that's why people avoid reading it, but please don't do that. Please read this book, because Forensic Medicine and Toxicology is a very interesting subject. And trust me on this, if you read this book, you will genuinely develop real love for the subject. So, please read this book. I know it seems like a big book. So you read it, the topics that are relevant to your curriculum, you read only those topics. And because it's such an interesting subject, you'll end up reading the entire book. All right. So this is one book. Many people use Cingal as their prep guide for FMT. Now, the problem with Cingal is it has only notes. All right. There is no explanation. There is just points. So people generally use it to pass exams. But the problem here is you will never understand FMT. In case you want to use this book, please use it with a standard textbook. Take notes from this book and then attach it to the Cingal, and that's how you can use this book. But please, please, please do not use Cingal alone. You will never know the beauty of FMT as a subject. There's another book which is by Gautam Vishwas. This is a review of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology. This is based on the new curriculum. Now, we didn't have this book at our times, but I think it's a beautiful book. The more I talk about this book, it's less. Everything is represented in a modular pattern, so everything is point-wise. So you can use it for understanding your concepts as well as writing answers in the exam. There are beautiful pictures. You know, you'll see injury marks pictures. And then there are also relevant medico-legal cases. And for example, acid attacks, morphine poisoning. So they have put like real life cases also, copper poisoning and all of that. So you will really enjoy reading this book. It's modular, point wise. I think this book will have you sorted. So this is an excellent book. Please read this book. For practicals in FMT, I think the journals are enough. You'll learn how to make death certificates. You'll learn about injury marks, and you'll learn about weapons and everything. Apart from that, you'll have to attend postmortems, and that will also be very interesting. So that's it about FMT. Moving on to ophthalmology. Now, there are two standard books that you use, but Parson is the gold standard for ophthalmology. This is a really good book. It has all the concepts are very beautifully explained in this book. So if you really want to in-depth understanding about ophthal, then I think Parson is the book that you go for. The only problem is everything is given in blocks of paragraphs. So it does become a little difficult to, you know, write answers and everything. But if you make notes from Parson, I think you are sorted, and it has accurate information to the point. You can really understand the concepts of ophthal really well. Now, there's another book, Khurana, which many people use. Now, what Khurana has tried to do in the book is they have tried to make it more modular, make it point-wise, and also tried to explain the concepts. But sometimes it really gets a little confusing. But otherwise, it's a good book. And they have also tried to explain concepts wherever necessary. But a better explanation is always present in Parson in a very lucid manner. There's another book, which is Basak. This book is actually smaller than the other two textbooks. Now here, you will have pictures and everything, and it has actually tried to make it more concise. The good thing about this book is it has beautiful line diagrams that you can replicate easily in exams. You can use it as a prep manual just before the exams for revision. It has also included certain practical aspects of ophthalmology. So I think this is also a nice book to refer. Okay, and another book for ophthalmology is known as SOCH. SOCH stands for Simplified Ophthalmology Conceptual Handbook. It's written by Utsav Bansal. Now, this book really helps you with your NEET PG or next preparation, along with helping you in your UG. Everything is concise. You can use it as a review book or your prep manual, along with any of the standard textbooks like Parsec. It will really help making ophthalmology easy. For practicals, when we talk about the equipments, you will need a torch, so you could buy that. In the practical books, again, there is a practical handbook by Basak, which you can use. The only thing is, it's short, sweet. Everything that you need on ophthalmology is covered, but it's all black and white, okay? The other option that you have is Dada Peer. Now, again, it is a short book for practicals. The advantage that you have here is, it has a lot of colored images, all right? And there are also individual case presentations. Here, you'll just have a case performa. Here, you'll have individual case presentations and also a lot of Viva questions that can be asked. So I think you could use Dada Peer for a practical book. It's a good option. All right. So I'll just quickly revise for Ophthal. You have Parsons, Khurana, Basak for theory. So which is again a prep manual that you can use. And for practicals, you can go for Basak or Dada Peer. But please, I would recommend that read Parsons for Ophthal. It's a beautiful book and you should definitely read the standard textbook. Let's move on to ENT, which is ear, nose, throat. So Dhingra is one book that is the most widely used in India. Now, this book is concise, modular presentation. It has made ENT really very concise. The only thing is, the concepts are not very comprehensively explained in this book. But yes, it can do very well for third year of medicine. But in case you want to know things more in depth and comprehensively, the standard book is Logan Turner. The only thing about this book is that it is based on European guidelines. But it has a narrative flow, okay, lucid approach, and also a concept clarifying approach. So that's the standard book, Logan Turner. One more book that you can use is Sakshi Arora. Now, again, it is a prep manual. It can be used for NEET PG preparation, help you in that also. And it will help you to make like short notes of whatever is given. So I think as a revision book, you can use this. And as a self-assessment book, you can use Sakshi Arora for ENT as well. For practicals, Vikas Sinha is a short book. Nothing is explained in too much detail, but for third year, I think it is good enough. If you want something more comprehensive than Vikas Sinha, go for a book called Hazarika. It has a more holistic and comprehensive approach towards practicals in ENT. Vikas Sinha is just the necessary concepts and everything is explained too briefly. And so if you want a little more information, you could go for Hazarika as a practical book for ENT. Let's move on to PSM, which is Preventive and Social Medicine. Now, don't get scared by looking at these big books. It is a vast subject. It starts from first year and it goes on till your final year. But third year, it becomes a major subject and you have to give like your MUHS exams. But you have exams for PSM from the first year onwards. So these are really big books. I'll talk about them later. You can use them for weightlifting also, like they work. So I'll start with first year. Okay, so in first or second year for PSM, you can use these books. For example, a book called as Seshu Babu. It has only question and answer format. Okay, so you can use like for your exams in first and second year. The thing with this book, and there's another book which is Ibrahim Patel. Now this is also a really nice book. The only thing with these two books is that they're not updated. So you have to be very careful while using them. And the second thing with Ibrahim Patel, it has beautiful line diagrams and you know, certain short answer questions. I think it has been beautifully dealt with. So you can use Ibrahim Patel for a lot of things. All right, even stats and all these formulas are given really nicely. So this is one book that you can definitely use Ibrahim Patel. And the other book is Seshu Babu. Question answer format, you can use it before your exams. Nice book. When we come to third year and you want a book for PSM, the one that many people and generally is recommended is Park, Preventive and Social Medicine by Park. Really heavy book, really big book. Now, again, here you don't have to read everything, but you have to read concepts which are, you know, relevant to your curriculum. Also, this book has a lot of stats. The information is presented in blocks of content. So, you know, it is a somniferous book. You tend to fall asleep by reading this. So, yeah, this is one option that you have, that is Park. The other option that you have is another book by Indian Association of PSM. Now, this is based on the recent curriculum, or like the recent medical curriculum. The good thing about this book is it has a lot of diagrams, a lot of tables. Then you have chapter summaries. And the one thing that I really liked about this book, it has case scenarios based on PSM, which is very rare to find in other books. So I think even the competencies are mentioned chapter wise, and even they have tried to make the content more modular, like they have separated it into headings and subheadings. So I think this is a really good book to refer to. Now, there's another book which is written by WHO along with AFMC, which is Armed Forces Medical College. So I think this is their textbook of community medicine. I think if you want a more comprehensive approach towards medicine, you can go through it, but not like I wouldn't recommend it, honestly, because PSM is generally too vast and this book is also like super vast. So you could go for either Parks or this book by Indian Association of PSM. Now, apart from these books, there is one book that please close your eyes and just buy this book. It's called Vivek Jain. Now, this is a prep manual for NEET PG, but you can easily write answers for your even MUHS theory exams from this book. It makes everything, everything is point-wise, concise. It makes PSM so much easier, so much more palatable. So close your eyes and buy this book and you will be sorted for PSM for the entire year. You can read these books like Park and the other book that I mentioned for your knowledge and more comprehensive approach towards PSM, but please buy Vivek Jain because there's a lot to cover and you have to do it in a limited time frame. So Vivek Jain really helps you in that. That's it for PSM. And before investing in any medical textbook, because it's really expensive, please go to the library and see the book and assess it for yourself. Look at the content, see the presentation, study one topic from that book and see if it suits your taste and your study methods. That's all for today's video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. Click the bell icon so that you don't miss any video that we upload. I will try and put the links to all the books and equipments in the description below so that if you want to purchase them, you can do that there. Also, you can follow me on Instagram. I put the handle right here. And thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you soon. Love and peace.